Good morning, dear students. In the last session, we have completed the unit 1, and now coming session, we will start with the unit 2, that is the size reduction. First of all, this is the syllabus or this is the content of the size reduction that we are going to cover. Mainly, we have to discuss the crushing laws, classification of the size reduction equipments. We will see the principle, construction and working of the each equipment. And this is the CO which is mapped with your unit 2, that is apply size reduction concept to related equipment and assess their performance. Now, first of all, what is the need of the size reduction? Why we should go for the size reduction? Because once we reduce the size, it is easy to transport, it is easy to store. We are getting the homogeneous mixture. As the size is reduced, the surface area is increases, and as the surface area is increases, the reactivity will also increase. So these are some of the advantages of the size reduction. Now there are basically four mechanisms of the size reduction. One, that is the compression, impact, attrition and the cutting. Compression, the simple example of the compression, we can say that is the nut cracker, right? And this is how we apply the compression. Impact, the very simple example of the impact, that is the hammering that we are doing. We are applying the positive pressure on it by hammer and it will convert it into the smaller size. Third one, that is the attrition, or we can say that is the rubbing action. So that is the third mechanism. And fourth one, that is the cutter, or we can say the daily routine example of that, that is the scissor, or we can say knife also. So to get the particles into the proper shape, generally we go with the cutters. So these are the basically four different mechanisms of the size reduction. Now coming to the laws of the size reduction. See, we start with the crushing efficiency, what is the crushing efficiency, and then we derive these three laws. So basically, sometimes the size reduction is also known as the comminution. So that is nothing but to convert the larger size of the particle to the smaller size. So these are the basically three laws. One, that is the Ritinger's law, King's law and the Pond's law. So as per the statement of the Ritinger's law, the work required in crushing is proportional to the new surface created. The King's law said that the work required for crushing a given mass of material is constant for the same reduction ratio, and the reduction ratio, that is the ratio of the feed size to the product size. And Pond's law, which is considered as the more realistic, we say that the work required to form particle of size dp from the very large size of the feed is proportional to the square root of surface to volume ratio of the product. So we have to derive the mathematical formula of these three laws, and then we have to solve the sums based on the above theory. Thank you.